Hey guys, Nature Boy here, and today I'm going to show you how to make a fire with flint and steel. So felt off, you'll need something dry, like dry grass, maybe, something dry. And you'll need wood or kindling sticks, some big logs once it gets going. Like small sticks. Steel, of course, and your flint. And if you have a magnesium block, it really helps if things are a little wet. Step one. You're not going to need all of it at first, because you don't want to waste it all in case it doesn't go so well the first time. But get a small amount, maybe crushed up a little, and make it so you can get a little hole in the center for if you have magnesium. It may take a little while for you to get the magnesium or the amount of magnesium you want, but try to use the bottom of your blade or heel, whatever, and start at the top with the blade facing towards you, and then push and turn. I didn't put all the magnesium in, but if the stuff is sort of wet, you should get amount that's sort of the length or the width or whatever of a bottle cap, and close together too, not spread out. This is all spread out. So try to hold it like this. If you have a block, the end in the web of your thumb and your pointer finger. And again, use the heel and slowly but hard shoot it or hit the sparks onto the magnesium. Gotta get your wood. Take that over. Do not burn your magnesium because that is the most helpful thing you'll have. Ah! I lost that back there. Once you get your fire going, keep adding stuff, but again, don't smother it. That will just put it out. And then once you're for sure it's all lit and all that, start adding bigger pieces. Don't be afraid to get burned either. It can be an issue at some time. And I'd also say add wood in the way the wind's blowing, because if the wind's blowing the fire, it will blow the fire into the wood and burn it. This one's almost ready for a big log. Also, with the wood, if it's dry, or if it's light, it's generally dry. So try to get light pieces of wood. Blowing on the fire does help a lot. Now, if you follow these tips step by step, you will make a fire. It may not happen the first time or the second time, but you will. It just takes practice. And again, dryer lint or cotton balls. I didn't use them in this video, but if you use them, trust me, it will help a lot. So if you know you're gonna use flint and steel to make a fire, use dryer lint.